Bam, those are true.
In this video and in the next video to follow, we're going to do four basic constructions and learn how to use a couple of basic tools in geometry. Tools that in very, very early geometry, way back when it was developed by the Greeks and the Babylonians and such, these were very, very important tools. Now we have compasses and rulers, but a protractor and rulers, and it makes measurements easier. But these are core important tools in geometry, and there's actually studies in college of plane geometry and Euclidean plane geometry where the whole course is basically just using these two tools to do things like bisect angles and other whatnot. So we're just going to do some basic construction. So a compass and a straight edge. Now, this is a yardstick, okay? I'm sure you can see in the camera that it has measurements on it. A straight edge does not have measurement. That's the purpose of it. That's what the compass does, is take measurements. So a straight edge really doesn't have, like, you know, inches or centimeters marked on it to take measurements. So we're going to talk about constructing a congruent segment and a congruent angle in this video, and then in the next video we're going to bisect those. So I have a segment already given, and we are going to walk through these three steps to use a compass and straight edge to draw a congruent segment. I already have part of this set up. Now, nowadays, and if you have a ruler, you know, we can just go, well, let's see here. Okay, that appears to be about 12 inches long. Let's put this down and go and mark off 12 inches and we're done. But again, that's using a ruler. And let's not forget, congruent segments are simply two segments that have the same length. It's a very simple geometric structure. So length is all we can measure, and that's all we need. Two congruent segments simply have the same measure or same length. Okay, so it doesn't matter what direction it goes in. Draw a ray. Okay, a ray, we need an endpoint, and it just extends forever. We can measure lengths of segments. I just did. It was approximately 12 inches long. We can do that because it has two endpoints, and thus it does not extend forever. The length of this ray right now, with the arrow indicating the direction of movement, has a length of infinity. It goes on forever. It doesn't matter that I can put a ruler on here and say it's, you know, X number of inches or centimeters long. It's extending forever with the arrow. But we have set our one endpoint. Measure the given segment with your compass. Now, if we have a compass, we're going to put, this is a rubber tip, so this would be like the sharp side of your compass and the chalk for the pencil end. And we're going to open this up and put the point on one end and the chalk at the end, well, that was a lucky guess, at the end of the segment that we're given. Now, if you don't have a compass, or if you're, saying like doing construction, you know, we can just use like string on me as my lanyard here, and I can, you know, put my thumb here and measure off that length with my lanyard and set that. And then this can kind of be my compass on my other segment if you wanted to sort of improvise with some just random like string maybe, and let that, along with your finger, act as a compass. But we have a compass. So we're going to measure that. So voila. We're going to put the point, this will be my rubber side, put the point of your compass, the sharp needleless point of your compass, on the end point of your ray and mark. We're going to do that by rotating the compass and make an arc, which is going to be our mark. The intersection between the arc that you draw and the ray is going to be the new end point of your congruent segment which you're attempting to draw. So this is very, very quick. All we have to do is point on the one end point that we have so far, make an arc through that ray, and if you have a good compass with the screw bolt that goes between, it's impossible to change the adjustment of that compass. If you have just a compass that works on friction, you have to work a little bit hard on holding it carefully. I like to hold it on the pivot point to make sure, attempt to try and make it sure it doesn't open or close after you take that measurement, because it's endpoint, chalk at the other endpoint, or your pencil, measure that, and then you're trying to transfer that equal measure onto the ray. And of course, if your compass opens and closes, you're going to get the wrong measurement. So try and hold your compass carefully, or maybe even have a really good one. That's almost impossible to misalign or change its setting without intention. What you can also do with a pencil, if you're just using string, is thumb here, measure it, and then bring that thumb down here, and again make your arc. It's going to be a bit more difficult to make that exact measurement, but it's if you need to, you can do that. Well, now this intersection is going to be my new endpoint, and once I have my initial endpoint from the ray and this new endpoint of the intersection of the arc or the mark that you made in the ray, we just come with our pencil, erase that, and now we have a congruent segment, an exact, pretty much as best we can with a piece of pencil lead, an exact match of the original segment given to us. Now, let's talk about drawing a congruent ray. Certainly a few more steps, but hopefully be easy to understand. Okay, we have 5 steps for drawing a congruent angle using a compass and straight edge. We're going to draw a ray. We're going to, with the point of our compass on the vertex of the given angle, we're going to make an arc through that angle and label the intersection point. So let's get that part done right now. So we're going to take our straight edge. We're going to just, you know, draw a ray somewhere. I'm going to try not have this going exactly the same direction because I want you to realize that that's not really necessary. So let's just say the ray is going, let's see, this way. Okay, fairly straight. So now what we got? We have our ray. Okay, step one. With the point of our compass on the vertex of the given angle, make an arc through the angle. All right, now I'm not taking any measurements. I just need an arc going through this given angle that I can use as reference. So I can't have it extend, of course, beyond the angle. So I'm going to shrink this up a little bit. And that's loosening up my compass as I go. So let's tighten it. Okay, my rubber side, the point of your compass on the vertex, and draw an arc through that given angle. Now we're going to label those intersection points, and let's call that A and B. Okay, so this is going to be point A, and this point B. Okay, now what? Make an arc through your ray with the same compass setting. So thankfully I didn't move this around too much. I'm going to double check it anyway. Make an arc through the ray, that would be here, with the same compass setting. Let's make sure that was still correct. Okay, yep, still hitting. So now I'm going to put the point of my compass on the end point of my ray and just make an arc, and ultimately we want to copy this ray, so you need your arc length to be about the same. So point on the end point, and let's just swing this around a little bit. Oh, I'm also leaning the compass sort of in the direction, and I'm trying to pull it around. You don't want to push it. That's going to make the pencil bounce possum. So I'm kind of like leaning it this way, and I'm pulling it across the board. And that should be fine, okay? Make an arc through the ray. All right. Measure the distance between the marked points on your given angle. So in that case, it'd be A and B. All right, so let's do that. So point where the arc intersects the other ray of your angle and measure that, get it to be as equal as you can. That's pretty good. Measure the distance between the marked points and the given angle. With that setting, so don't move your compass, put the point on the intersection of the arc and ray and make another arc through the first arc. What? Okay, what am I trying to say? I want you to take this setting that we just measured from point A to point B, go to the ray that we're trying to draw the new one, put the point of your compass on that intersection point. Probably would have been easier if I'd labeled it. Let's call that point C. And I want to make an arc going through the first arc that we just drew a second ago. So that's going to go, okay, about right there. The intersection of those two arcs needs to be marked again with another variable or with another letter. So let's call this point D, and now that I'm, you know, trying to label everything, let's see here. This is point O. I got D and C. How about we call this first endpoint E? Okay. So measure the distance. We did that. Setting, did that. Make an arc. And now we're done. We're going to draw a ray from the endpoint of the ray, where we're trying to copy the angle, through the intersecting arcs, which we now have labeled as D, okay? And that's going to be it. So we're going to take our straight edge. We are going to, again, put it on the end point of our ray. the right color chalk. Also having it go through the point defined by the two intersecting arcs that we just made. And voila, we have copied a congruent angle without using a protractor to measure off the number of degrees that are in that angle and just simply copy it again using these more basic tools that were used to help develop geometry of a compass in a straight edge. If I did have a gigantic protractor, the number of degrees inside this angle BOA or angle AOB would be the same if I used my two tools correctly as angle CED, or of course you'd have the letters in reverse order, angle DEC. And if their measures are equal, that means those angles are congruent. So, I'm Mr. True. We're going to move on to our next video where we're going to bisect an angle and bisect, make a perpendicular bisector of a segment. If you don't need that, well, I'm Mr. True. Go do your homework.